Welcome back to my channel, friends. This side Sonia here, and it's time to share a new tutorial on mixed media tag. I'm really excited to share this tutorial because I love creating mixed media tag, and when I got these papers from Zero Brands, and I was really excited to do some creative work on these tags and use these papers. So to start with, I have this beautiful background decoupage paper, and I thought of creating this mixed media MDF tag. I have already used this paper, the cutout from this, and the remaining portion is really beautiful. It has a beautiful dream catcher, and I thought of using that on my tag. So first I am going to mark my tag size, and then I'm going to do the cutting work. This is really simple. First you can stick it in, then you can do the cutting work. But I had time and I wanted to just enjoy my crafting, so I thought why not to do the easy and the slow process of crafting. So once I'm done with the marking, I'm going to do the cutting work with my favorite scissor. Like I have said in my previous video also, that I have a huge collection of scissor, and if you want to see that collection, please do comment below that you want to see my collection of scissors, and I will be really happy to make a tutorial or just a casual video on my scissor collection. So here now I am going to do the fussy cutting work. I love fussy cutting work, and that is one of my favorite thing to do. So here I need to start with the sticking work. So I'm going to apply a layer of Mod Podge. It's a matte finish Mod Podge on my base, and then I'm going to stick my decoupage paper. Now, as this is just a mixed media tag, this is not going to have any decoupage, any work on it, so you can even use your any liquid adhesive to stick the paper, because this is just going to be the sticking work. We are not doing any decoupage on this. So once I'm done with the sticking of paper and pressing and sticking it very nicely, it's time to move on to the next step. I love adding texture paste, shimmer paste, dazzle paste to my layout, and for this one I thought of using my dazzle paste. This color really goes well with my tag, and I really don't need to use any additional shade on it, so I'm going to use this dazzle paste color on my tag, and I'm using a Tim Holtz stencil to give it a nice texture on my base. As you can see, I'm covering almost all my dream catcher, because I thought of doing some more creative work on this, so I thought yes, we can hide this dream catcher, and this is how it looks. You can always use your palette knife or the plastic palette knife for applying this. When I started crafting, I used to use the butter knife, because I really I was not very sure on how to use the palette knife, and I was also a little bit constrained about the costing of it, because these are a little expensive tool. But yes, to start with, I started with a butter knife, and then I switched to my steel palette knife. But these palette knives are just awesome, because use it, wash it, use it, wash it, and these are like a lifelong thing for you. So yes, I have 4-5 varieties of palette knives, but this particular one is something which I always love using, and I use this on almost or the most of my videos, I can say. So now I'm going to dry my paste with my heat gun, and it looks like it has dried out now. and it's time to add some more shading work to it. So here I'm going to use my finger dauber, which I got from Nagashree Arts, and then I'm going to blend this dye ink pad brown shade, and I'm going to blend it on my edges. Before this step, please make sure that your texture paste or the modeling paste or the dazzle paste, shimmer paste, any paste, whatever you're using, has dried out completely. Otherwise, it is going to get smudged and ruin your project. So please move on to the shading step only when your paste has dried out completely. Now, blending the colors with this blending tool is really easy and super fun. So here I'm almost done with the shading part, and this looks fab now. I thought of adding some more flowers to it, and I wanted to do some stamping. It's been a long time since I've done some stamping work. So I did the reverse stamping. So usually what you do is you stamp and then you do the coloring work. Here what I'm going to do is I'm going to use my two shades, that is red and brown color. I'm going to do the blending work and then I'm going to stamp it. Now for this step, please make sure that your stamped image is a little smaller than the colored image so that you can have the complete stamped image. Like here, once I was done with the stamp with my blending color, I actually checked it if this works perfectly, and it does. And now I'm going to stamp my image. Now for the blending colors, I had used dye based ink, and for the stamping I am going to use my Ekavil permanent ink pad, because if in future I wanted to add some more layer to it or some texture or some kind of experiment to it, this color is not going to fade away for sure. If you feel you need to give some extra texture or blending, you can definitely add the colors. Like here I thought of adding one more flower to it, and then you can, in the same way, you can add some more shades to it. So here I am going to stamp one more flower for my tag, and this looks cool now. It's time to do some fussy cutting work. I love, love, love fussy cutting work because this is something which I really enjoy, and this is something which is really like soothing experience when you're really tired, don't want to do anything, then do the fussy cutting work. So I actually have a book filled with stamped image where I do watercoloring whenever I'm free or I'm stressed out or I'm really tired of doing anything and I don't want to do anything and just sit and do coloring and some relaxing things. So I have a book full of stamped image where I keep on stamping and then I do coloring as and when I need, and then I also do the fussy cutting work. I use those images on my crafting. So here I am going to do all the flowers fussy cutting work, and once they are done we'll move on to the next step. So my flowers look really pretty after the fussy cutting work, and I'm really happy with the coloring, a big pad for myself. And now it's time to add some more texture, some more layers to it. My stamping, fussy cutting, layering, everything is done, and it's time to assemble my project. And for this I'm going to use this jute ribbon and I'm going to stick it on the center. Now, like I said, I love using cardboard pieces for adding depth to my project. So here what I'm going to do is, instead of sticking my ribbons, I am going to stick my cardboard pieces, then stick my flowers on the top of it with the layering. And as my jewel piece is already on the base, it is going to get stuck between the flowers, so I really don't need to stick it, and this is actually going to give it a very natural look. So I am going to do it, and then once I'm done with the sticking work, the layering and everything, then I'm going to stick my sentiment. Initially I thought I'll stick it on side, and then I thought the center one is going to look good. So this is the best part of using your liquid adhesive. You can actually take the adhesive, apply it. If you want, you can remove it. It is going to be a transparent, non-glossy one, and you can remove your embellishments or your sentiments. It becomes really easy. Now once I'm done with everything, I'm going to mark my hole which was already there in my MDF tag, make a nice circle, nice hole for my thread, and then I am going to use the same jute piece and give a nice tie to my tag, and it's ready. So I hope you all enjoyed this tutorial. All supplies used in this video are listed in description box below, attaching few more pics of this tags. And if you have any queries, please do comment below. Also, if you want to see the collection of my scissors, please do mention the comment section below. I will make definitely a video on my scissors for you guys. Thank you so much for watching.